This early, lawmakers are saying it will be up to the next administration to fix supposed loopholes in the anti-money laundering law, with allegations Philippine casinos were used in money laundering. Senator Sergio Smeña anticipates international pressure to plug the loopholes, justifying amends to the law. Smeña notes it's so easy to launder money through casinos, real estate, and artworks.
Art has been one of the biggest ways to launder money. Then, of course, the real estate, the same, no? You have somebody buy the real estate, and then he'll transfer it to you, then he'll sell it. And eto, this is gambling winnings, see? Pagpasok mo sa casino, mag-exchange ka. So meron kang either cash or manager's check. Sasabihin mo sa casino, give me $100,000 worth of chips. O, tapos, after 1 hour, kinas mo yung chips. Sinauli yung $100,000 mo. May excuse ka na ngayon, no? I want this in the casino.
Smeña says he will file an amendment to the AMLA. But as early as yesterday, this ranking House official already passed on the task to the next Congress.
The Congress will, I'm very confident, do what is necessary. At any rate, we have to do it because there is also pressure being exerted on our central bank.
Yet, the bill identifying casino operators as persons covered under the Anti-Money Laundering Act of 2001 has been languishing in the plenary of the House of Representatives. Authored by House Banking Committee Chairman Sonny Colyantes, the committee endorsed the bill on September 29, 2015, and since then has been in the official business of the plenary. In the bill, casinos also refer to both internet casinos and ship-based casinos. They'll have to report transactions of more than 4 million pesos and establish and record, using official documents, the identities of their customers, engaging in a single or an aggregate transaction of over 200,000 pesos. The bill requires that records of transactions of customers are to be maintained for at least 5 years, even as it also ensures the confidentiality. The casino gaming industry tried to block this again. Congressional records show the Entertainment City Estate Management Incorporated wrote the committee in March 2014 on behalf of four companies running casinos. The position paper cited the growing casino industry in the country and notes that the Financial Action Task Force already identified casinos as one of the non-financial businesses vulnerable to the threats of money laundering. Still, the position paper reasserted that casinos should not be among the covered institutions and rejected the proposed revisions. Smeña says the Senate will probe the allegations of money laundering through Philippine casinos next week. And this time, Smeña adds, casinos will have no choice but to face the music. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.